everybody. I've got another $1,000 strap shirt search to go through here. Got $1,000 in $1 bills. We are looking for old dollar bills made before 2001, error notes, whatever errors we might find in here, interesting serial numbers, and star notes. So, let's get going here. I forgot the music evidently here. Let me turn some of that on. Stupid ads. Oh my god, and another one. Alright, well, let me make sure these are all faced the correct way here before we begin. They all look good. For about a year now. Quad fives there, 2018. Got an interesting CO number. I don't think it's worth holding on to. Thank you. Not a thing in that first strip. Heck yeah! Look at that! Look at that! I haven't found one of these in a minute. That is always a welcome sight. We got a binary there. Look at that. Focus in here. Sevens and ones. That is what you want to see when you're strap hunting right there. That is a keeper. First fancy serial number that I have found in a while. That is awesome. I could find nothing else this whole search, and I would be happy. That is a great find. Let me go back to that. Only thing that could possibly make it better is if it was ones and zeros. Ones and sevens is great. I will keep that every day. Thank you. saw are these, but facing the wrong way. For the first two, strap number three. Quite a bit of transfer from the previous bill that was on there. You can see all those speckles on it. When the red ink hit the one, you know, next sheet. Star note. Wow, there's another one right after it. I should email this person. I'm gonna hold on to that. Think about that. I'm gonna think about whether or not I should email them. Thank you. star note. It's the third one in the strap. And the third one in the hunt. Stars, one kind of oddity. Still no old bills. That's worth holding on to for the moment. 1988A. A real beat up. First old note we found, I'll hold on to it. If I don't need it for the book, I'll probably wind up spending it on something I want for my book. I want for the collection. It's kind of how she goes. I'll save stuff like that, but if I see something I want at the coin shop, I am liable to spend that. Find one and then I have to write on the strap what I found. So that is a strap 4. Okay. Star note. Thank you. foot five was a 6 or a 9 or an 8, it'd be a perfect flipper. Or a 0. That was strap number 5. Coming in hot with number 6, and look at that. It's not a true ender, I would say. But 1988A, and that's in decent shape. But for having it on the end of the thing, even though it's only a $25. I think that's pretty good. So, you know that 88A is in there. Will we find anything else to go along with it? Let's see. Thank you. think this is one I actually need for the book. 1988, a Kansas City or Dallas. Nope. I don't think I do. Star. Strip number 6. We got 4 more to go. And these last 4 came from the same bank. I went in normally like I do. And oh, I didn't write. Just a second, I'll finish my story here in just a second. So we got a 1988, a Fort Worth from Dallas. So I went in there the first time like I normally do, and right when I walk in, you know, by this time the bank tellers pretty much know why I'm there. And she said, the bank teller said, oh, I'm counting up some ones right now for you. So I said, great. You know, got the regular 200 that I do. And, you know, she asked if there was, if I needed any more. And I said, no. So I went out and sat there. And I didn't think that for what I wanted to do to get coin and dollar bills, I didn't think that I would be able to go to enough branches to get all that I wanted. So I thought, well, she's got another $200 in there. I might as well go ask her for it. So I went back in and got 200 more. So I got 400 from the same bank, basically. So let me go through here and see if anything interesting was turned in. I think these were all turned in from the same person. She had $500 there, so I got 400 of it. So these first two that I'm searching are from my first trip in there. Could have been a waitress or waiter, someone like that, turning in all of those $1 bills that they had saved up. Thank you. Excuse me. Star note. Two star notes. So this is the second one from my first trip into that bank branch. Excuse me, getting late for me, 1 o'clock. Lord. If anybody likes what they're seeing here, go ahead and I guess give me a follow. Drop a comment there if you want. Any questions or comments that anybody has, you can post them in the live stream or also in the chat for the page, and I will try to respond to that in my next live stream. Okay. Hey, there we go. There's something. 1995. Not a web note. The A3 there tells me that it's not a web note. at 95 is one that I need. I think I actually found that one on stream already. Hey, there's a 1999. I was just thinking that I haven't found any 1999s in a while. Fort Worth, Minneapolis. Straps, and these last two are from my second trip in. Bunch of ink there on that top one and not on the bottom one. That's kind of interesting, but I think it's worth saving. Note. Hey, look at that. 1974, Chicago. Ooh, whoa. I doubt I need that one. Yeah. I don't think I need that one, but still. 1974, that's in good shape. That's definitely a keeper. That's why you go back in, I guess. I don't think I'm going to be able to add anything to the book today. Unless I find something yet. And the last one's a star note. Okay, so, oh, I didn't write that down. We got a 1974 Jeep. And the last strap of the search. Starting to kind of run low on dollars to replace. It's okay, I feel like I'm always adding more. More to it, but hey, I guess that just goes to show what I'm saving. That 70s one, I doubt I'll ever spend that, but let's see. The rest of these, maybe not that 88A, but that, but this one, like, I'll definitely spend that, and maybe that 1999. I'll be at the coin shop one day, and there'll be something that I see that I want. And I, you know, I won't have all the money, or there'll be something else that I already bought, and I'll come back to the house, flip through, grab a bunch of stuff that isn't really worth saving, and go back and spend it. That's how I got this $100 gold certificate. It's basically how I got my $5 Hawaii note. I went and sold a bunch of silver that I had for that. Look at that. Star note, second one in. Bam. That was a sight for sore eyes. I thought that was an alternator, but I don't think it quite is. There's one of those, if you squint real hard and kind of cock your head to the side, it looks like one, but I don't think it was. Hey, look at that, 1963B, love finding those. I am almost certain that I do not need that for my collection. Yeah, the only one that I need is Richmond, Virginia, E. But that's a nice one, that's a nice find. Always love finding them. Joseph Barr was in the position for just a few months, so people thought that notes with his signature would be rare, but they actually printed quite a few of them, so they are not rare, and since people thought they would be rare, they held them back, only to find years and years later that they're not worth anything, so they just spend them. Collection of them, and I don't know that I could ever bring myself to spend them, even though they are only worth a dollar, especially to me, to someone who's only paid a dollar to find them. Another star note there. So, I guess that's another reason why you go back in, is that 74 and that 63B. You got three on that one. There's three. So, a little bit of a recap here. In just a second. Alright. A little bit of a recap. I found that series 1988A, another 1988A, a 1995, 1999, 1974, that's actually still in pretty good shape, and a 1963B. I don't need any of those for my book. Oops. I don't need any of those for my book. I also found, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 star notes to go through. I also found this binary note, which I have got this unopened package of currency sleeves here. I'll go ahead and use one of them. It's a currency sleeve and it works, but I don't know how well I like those. I got a whole pack of them. It says that there's 100 of them in here. Holy smokes. Well, that'll take me a while to get through. I think I might have gotten those for free from a from like a coin show or coin club Christmas party thing or something. I don't know. I don't remember paying for them. They work. So, let's see. Oh yeah, I also found this one. That weird Gmail thing. I might shoot her an email and see what that was all about. Well, I think that's it. And, oh, no, I didn't write on my thing the 1963B. Another Chicago. Chicagos are very common for me to find. Living in Indiana and whatnot, we are quite close to Chicago. Well, within a day's drive anyway. Close for U.S. standards. Alright, well, yeah, I'm not gonna search through my book since I'm pretty certain that I don't need any of those. One of them might be an upgrade. I'll search through it just to see if one of them is an upgrade, but I'm pretty certain I don't need any of those for my book. So I'm gonna go ahead and end the stream here. Thank you for joining me for, what was this, hunt number 5? Found, I mean, that's a great find, a binary. I'm always happy to find that. If you enjoyed the stream, go ahead and give me a like and a comment and a follow. Go ahead and follow me, and I suppose I'll follow you back. Thank you for stopping by.